What's up, cannabis growers, and welcome back to GreenBox Grown. In today's video, I'm going to show you guys my new light meter and to show you how to properly distance your grow light for maximum yields. Now, before we get started, I'd like to mention, as always, to check out our merch online at greenboxgrown.com under the merch and smoke section. And also don't forget to check out our link down below in the description to visit my Patreon page, where you can sign up for one-on-one grow advice from myself. And basically, I'll be guiding you each day through your grow from seed to harvest, so you can learn as you go without making any mistakes, and so you get the best results possible. All right, now that you guys know what we're doing today's video, let's get started. All right, guys, so before we start testing different lights out with this meter, I wanted to give you a quick overview of it. And what this reads in is Lux as well as FC, which stands for foot candles. You don't really need to use that. I just use the Lux reading. And these meters are different than PAR meters. So for most Lux readers, they don't work well with LED lights. This one happens to work well with them, so I will be using it with an LED light. Lux meters are perfect for HPS and metal halide bulbs and stuff like that, other incandescent lights. But for LEDs, you're supposed to use a PAR meter. That's what's highly recommended. But today I'll be using this Dr. Meter Lux meter because it does work with the LEDs. And all you have to do is take this cap off once you have the reader turned on, and you're going to place this under the light source to get a reading of how strong it is. And I'll give you guys a little more details on that once we are outside under the lights. But just wanted to give you guys a quick overview of what this looks like. All right, so now we're gonna hang up a 900 watt Viper Spectra LED, a Mars Hydro 300 watt LED, and then a Mars Hydro 480 watt from the reflector series. And I'm gonna give you guys an idea of how far the power of the light, or how quickly the power of the light dissipates as you go away from it or get further away from it. And I'll also show you how large of a footprint the lights have and how the power of the light differentiates from the different corners and as you go from the middle towards the outside of the footprint. All right, now let's head outside to check that out. Okay, we're now outside in the grow room, and you can see I've got, this is the 900 watt Viper Spectra LED, and it's exactly 24 inches from the canopy of these auto flowers down below. So let's get in closer. I'm going to show you guys, give you guys some readings with the Lux meter and show you what the readings are at the canopy as well as towards the outskirts of the footprint, and to show you a little closer how powerful the light really is. All right, so here's the meter a little bit more up close. It's going to be in Lux. That's going to be the unit of measurement. And for vegetation, the range you're going to want to be looking for, the minimum is about 40,000 and the max is about 70,000. So somewhere in the middle there, like 55 is pretty good for veg, not really for seedling. And then once you're in flower, you're going to want to be in the range of 85,000. And that, you don't want to be at 85,000. That's going to be a little too much. That's going to be like full saturation of light for your plants. So that will probably stress them out, especially with the more sensitive strains. But you will want to be somewhere like 75,000, maybe a little higher. So I'm going to turn this baby on and get a few readings for you guys. So I'm going to be reading in the times 100 range. So right here, we're at about 30,000 lux. And again, this is a Lux reader, so it is good for, or this is better for incandescent like HPS lights, not as good for LED. This one does work, but it will probably give slightly less reading since it's not picking up all the lighting. But yeah, about 35,000 lumens here, or lux. And as you get closer, like right around here, it's about 50,000, 49 right there. This plant on the outskirts is lower. It's about 25, 21, 22. You can see out here, it's still at 20, so that's kind of nice. It's got a large footprint, and it gets lower the further out here we go, but all the way towards the edge of the grow room, it's still at about 10,000. So it's not too bad. This edge of the grow room, almost 12,000, 11.3. Let's see. And then if you go all the way up, you're at like 120,000, 130,000. So pretty good light. The power doesn't dissipate too quickly, and it doesn't get hot either, which is nice. Right now it's just on the veg switch, with the bloom switch, that boosts the reading. So now it's over 35 here, about 37, but not too much a difference. So one quick thing I left out, so like with the readings here at the canopy, like okay, right here, yeah, it's at 26.6. I'm saying though it's probably more like 35 because this is an LED, so it's not gonna pick up all the light range, but it is still at about 25,000 down here. So that is why I was saying the readings were a little higher than what it's showing on here, is because this is, like I said, the Lux meter, and you need a par meter to really get the full spectrum of light showing up, but close enough for me, and it's adding 10,000, 5 to 10,000 is a good estimate. Here we are now inside mi casa, and I've got the 480 watt, which is the green one on the left, and then the 300 watt, both by Mars Hydro. So first I'm gonna be testing out the 480. So I'm gonna turn on the veg switch only for right now and give her a little test. All right. So you can see this light's a lot more purple than the Viper Spectra. That's just kind of the Mars Hydro trait. So right here at about 1 foot, we're at 24,000, 25 almost, sorry. Down here at about 2 feet, we're at 10,000. So it dissipates pretty quickly, right up close. Now what's nice is this is built with two LED screens, reflector screens like this, so it does spread out the footprint a lot more. But yeah, I mean, this light is a lot weaker than the one I had, the Viper Spectra. But yeah, okay, so like right here I'm at 23,000. Again, these readings are a little low because it is isn't picking up all the lighting, but 15,000 here, 14. All right, let's check out with the bloom switch on as well. So that bumped it up a little bit. We're at 21, almost 22,000 right here. Max is like 100,000. We're on 30,000 about right here. 130 is about the max. All right, let's check out the Mars 300 now. All right, so here we go. This one's less purple. Okay, so up close, about 130,000 again right here. Not bad. And that's without the adjustment. We're at like 18,000, 19, 20. So this baby still puts off some good heat or good light. It's just you need to stay really close to it. We're at like 16 out here, 12,000, 10,000. So pretty good range. I think this meter is working better with this one too, since it's not as purple as the other light. All right, growers, so that's exactly how you would use your Par or Lux meter to optimize your lights. And again, now you can see exactly how useful this tool can be for increasing yields, because it's gonna allow you to see exactly how much energy your light's putting off and where that light is maxed out or where it's optimized. So you can adjust its height and your plant's location accordingly so that they're getting those optimum ranges like I was talking about earlier. And again, for veg, the range is 40,000 to 70,000 lux. And then for flower, it is 60 to 85,000. And you wanna stay within that range. You don't really wanna go to the max ends because that'll be too much or too little for your plants. Again, this product is available on the greenboxgrown.com store. Under the starter kits tab, just hit the grow lights button and you'll see this listed there with some other options for par meters and other lux meters. This tool is also great for determining your footprint or your grow light's footprint so that you know the perimeter of where your plants can be and the different ranges or the different amounts of light that they'll be receiving around that perimeter. All right, guys, that concludes my review and showing of how to use a Lux meter to optimize and maximize your yields from your grow light. If you guys enjoyed the video, please give it a thumbs up and comment below with your feedback. And also don't forget to subscribe to our channel and to turn on notifications for updates on my latest grows. As always, thank you guys for watching, and until next time, happy growing.